Today to come speak to with you about a new concept related to reducing deforestation. Unlike our other speakers today, I'll be focused today on a concept rather than a discussion of an actual project. Most specifically, we're looking at how we can leverage the experience that has been made used by NGOs and others who have been operating in this space to reduce deforestation. Two applications where we can bring in private capital. The pictures that we're demonstrating at this point in time look at unfortunate circumstances which indicate where we are today with respect to deforestation. We have ongoing practices in this region and in other regions in which large swaths of area continue to be deforested on a regular basis. What we're interested in is trying to determine how we can leverage from the experience of success in areas where deforestation has been reduced, but yet expand that and scale it up. So what I'd like to look at today is some ideas about how we might bring in additional capital beyond the capital that's available from governments or from companies' corporate social responsibility activities to move from the type of logging activity which is demonstrated now on the screen to a more improved, sustainable logging application, as this picture demonstrates in a project that's supported by the Rainforest Alliance for Sustainable Logging. Overall, in short, it appears that while we have lots of mechanisms that are available to reduce deforestation, most of them have counted on the concept that the carbon credit will in fact solve the deforestation issue. But at this point in time, we have the carbon credit, and we have government funds, and we still have deforestation. And we don't have enough of the reduced deforestation to take advantage of the opportunity that reducing deforestation presents in terms of reducing carbon emissions. In fact, at this point, we can reduce up to 40% of what our needed goals are for the 2020 emissions reductions by improving forestry practices and reducing deforestation. So if the carbon credit is not enough, what might be enough? Well, what it appears is that we need to involve more parties, more stakeholders who are not at the table at this point in time in the process of reducing deforestation. We clearly have actors now in private companies and in NGOs who are successfully changing land use patterns by using sustainable farming, in this case, sustainable logging in the picture. We also have sustainable coffee plantations, sustainable tea plantations, and we have other types of sustainable livestock agricultural activities which are going on. The issue is how can we get more companies in this value chain to move forward? That will require a level of public-private partnership, will require some frameworks, and it will require that the technologies and the task activities are de-risked. Basically, that we can share risk among larger groups and larger numbers of stakeholders. To that end, what we're seeking to do in this discussion section is review where successful projects, as the project on the left indicates from this picture, have succeeded, how they've succeeded, and how we could get more corporations to participate in these types of projects as part of their core sustainable business and land use for supply chains. Overall, we believe that that will require not only a basic legal framework, but it will also require that companies look at what the opportunities are within their value chains to take advantage of these local resources and to bring together additional global resources in an integrated value chain. To move from what we see as ongoing unsustainable agricultural processes to more compatible agricultural processes, as some of these pictures depict. We can change and learn from this experience where we've had success in environments where deforestation has occurred, but then organized agricultural activities, as demonstrated by this picture, have been constructed in a sustainable manner which reduce or eliminate ongoing deforestation. So in sum, we look to explore and determine if we can find partners to move forward, to identify a value chain and a group of de-risking activities so that we can bring in more capital, corporate capital, to augment and supplement activities that are already going on in the REDD space.